Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about UPSC pattern. In that UPSC pattern, what is the anthropology syllabus, what is the anthropology optional syllabus, and today I am going to simplify the anthropology optional syllabus in your UPSC civil services examination preparation. Come with me and we will simplify the syllabus. So anthropology syllabus simplification. So before that, I want to start with basics. That means in UPSC civil services syllabus pattern, in mains, so there is prelims, there is mains and interview, whereas prelims is only qualifying in nature and mains and interview is deciding in nature. In that mains, we have general studies, GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4 and general essay, 5 papers are present. And whereas for optional paper, we will be having 2 papers, paper 1 and paper 2. So in that way, each paper is 250, 250 into 5, 1250, and 250 into 2, 500, 1250 plus 500 is equal to 1750. And the decision and the deciding factor will be the optional marks. You can randomly ask any teacher, you can randomly ask any of your mentor or any of your ranker. Seniors, they will tell you the marks which you get in your optional will be the deciding factor. So this 500 marks is going to decode, or this 500 marks is going to become a deciding factor for your becoming an IAS or not. So in general studies 1, we will be having history, society and geography. In general studies 2, we will be having polity, governance and international relations. In general studies 3, we will be having economics, environment and internal security. And in general studies 4, we will be having ethics paper. And the last but not the least is general essay. This is with respect to general studies. Whereas coming back to optional subject, anthropology, you will be having 2 papers, anthropology paper 1 and anthropology paper 2. In anthropology paper 1, it is called as general anthropology, and paper 2 is called as Indian anthropology. So here in paper 1 of anthropology, we will be doing about the general understanding of the anthropology, the world understanding of the anthropology, the world anthropologists. These all things we will be discussing in paper 1 of anthropology, which is called as general anthropology. And in paper 2 of Indian anthropology, we will be discussing about Indian anthropology, how anthropology evolved in India. So what I did, I simplified the syllabus. Just in a nutshell, I want to simplify the syllabus and I want to make you sure that you understand what is there in paper 1 and what is there in paper 2. So my dear friends, in anthropology paper 1, as I told you early, 6 modules are there. General anthropology, evolution of man, how evolution of man happened. So everything with respect to evolution of man will be there. Number 2, socio-culture anthropology, society, culture, marriage, family, kinship, economic systems, political systems, religion. That is called as socio-culture anthropology. And third is anthropological theories. That means thought process. How anthropologists understood. What is the views of anthropologists with respect to culture, with respect to marriage system, with respect to family system, with respect to society. What are their views? What is their thought process will be there in anthropological theories. Very interesting. The views, the thought process, their mindset, that we will be discussing in anthropological thought. And the fourth is physical anthropology. In physical anthropology, the science point of view means genetics point of view, how evolution is happening and how it is responsible for proper health and any occurrence of diseases, mainly with respect to genetics, that we will be discussing in physical anthropology. Next will be applications of anthropology. So what all we studied, we will be applying, like paternity diagnosis, forensics, like defense, on defense sector, on sports sectors, on nutritional sectors. So applications we will be doing under this particular fifth module. And sixth module is general archaeology. It means tool remains, cultural remains, material remains, specimens. When we are doing excavations, what are all the specimens we are getting? We will be studying the specimens. So how the people might use this specimen. So by analyzing the specimen, we will be understanding the cultures of the primitive societies, cultures of the early societies. That is called as general archaeology. So these are the 6 modules which are present in anthropology paper 1. Evolution of man, socio-culture anthropology, anthropological thought, physical anthropology, applications of anthropology and general anthropology. So simplification, only these six models are there, modules are there. Next in anthropology paper 2, as I told you earlier, paper 2 is called as Indian anthropology, paper 1 is called as general anthropology. In paper 2, again we have 6 modules. In that 6 modules, number 1 is called evolution of man in India. So that one, this one, just the comparison, just understand, this is evolution of man generally. This is evolution of man in India. So in India, how the evolution happened. Number 2, Indian society and rural India. How Indian society evolved? India is synonymous with village. So what is village society? What is rural society? How globalization is impacting rural society? How Panchayati Raj system is impacting rural society? That we will be discussing in module 2. Everything about rural villages. Number 3, tribal India, tribes. Tribes, what are their problems? What is their solutions? What government took the steps in order to ameliorate the life of the tribes? Those are all things we will be discussing in tribal India. 4th, growth of anthropology in India as a discipline. Growth of anthropology as discipline in India. How anthropology is becoming that much big mammoth structure. How it evolved as a discipline in India. What are the reasons behind it? Who are the anthropologists responsible for the growth of the anthropology as discipline in India? That all we will be discussing in module number 4. And the 5th module is about application of anthropology on social issues. Regionalism, ethnic conflicts, communalism. So on the social problems, how we can apply the knowledge of anthropology and we can solve the social problems. That we will be discussing in module number 5. And the 6th module is Indian archaeology. Whereas 6th module of paper 1 is general archaeology. And 6th module of paper 2 is Indian archaeology. So understanding Indian way of materials. Specimens of India. So whether culture is existing in India or not. So Indian archaeology is paper 2 of India. That means Indian archaeology belongs to paper 2 and general archaeology belongs to paper 1. In this way, the total syllabus I simplified into 12 modules. Paper 1, 6 modules. Paper 2, 6 modules. So when you complete one module, you will be getting a lot of confidence. So that is the reason the anthropology is easy. You know, to take it as an optional. And it creates interest also. Why? Because we are doing in the daily life the same thing we are studying here. So in this way, I simplified anthropology. I think everyone understood about it. Please subscribe to my channel and thank you.